about to receive, may the Lord make you truly thankful.
What can you want to know for? Mr. Bumble, I shall scream.
No, you would pay for if I wanted something special that you couldn't say no. Did I nearly catch you smiling? Yes, I did, and it's beguiling. If your reach is close, I'll press it. Yes, you like me, come confess it. Yes, you do.
No, I don't.
Yes, you do. Will my pretty miss do?
I shall scream, scream, scream!
I pinch you one pinch from your shy protective shell. With my itchy one pinch, will my blithesome, buxom beauty let the suitor do his duty? Though his laugh is very large, dear, sit upon it, there's no charge, dear. Will you send me?
No, I shan't.
Will you send
me? I shall scream. I shall scream. For the safety of my virtue, I shall scream. Though your knee is rather cozy, see my cheeks are getting rosy.
Thank you.
our very liberal terms. £5?
Well, as a matter of fact, I was needing a boy.
Good. Then it's settled. £5, please.
If you please, sir. Cash upon liking, Mr. Bumble. Cash upon liking. Mrs. Salaberry!
What is it?
Would you have the goodness to come in here a moment, my dear?
What do you want? Well, what is it?
I was telling Mr. Bumble here...
Hello, Mr. Bumble.
Yes.
Hello, Mrs. Salaberry.
That we might consider taking in this boy to help with the shop.
Dear me, he's very small.
Aye, ma'am. He is rather small. There's no denying that. But he'll grow, ma'am. He'll grow.
Ah, I dare say he will. On our victuals and our drink. They're a waste of time, these workhouse boys. They always cost more to keep than what they're worth. Still, you men always think you know best. What are you going to do with him?
He has a certain melancholy look about him that I find quite interesting. I think he would make a delightful coffin follower.
A what?
Not just a regular coffin follower for the adults, but more for the children's train. It would be good to have someone more in proportion. The more I think of it, my dear, it's a superb idea.
For once, Henry, just for once, you might have a decent idea.
Yes.
What's your name, boy?
Oliver Twist, ma'am.
A singular name.
One of my own choosing.
Yours, Mr. Bumble?
Mine, Mrs. Salaberry.
How's that, Mr. Bumble?
The boy's mother came to us destitute. Brings a child into the world, takes one look at him, and promptly dies. Without leaving a forwarding name or address.
Dear, dear. Well, Oliver Twist, do you think that you can look like a gentleman?
Yes, ma'am. If I had a tall black hat.
Never mind about black hats.
The boy's quite right, Henry. Get the boy a top hat. These things must be done proper and correct. Stand here, let me see. Yes, Henry, give us the top hat. Henry, really? It takes you twice as long to do anything as anyone else. Yes. Yes. Henry, for once, you've had a good idea. Do you think you can keep that expression for a long time with a crowd watching you?
Yes, ma'am. I think so.
Fixed.
Thank you. make haste, because he'll be asked to watch the shop this afternoon. Do you hear? Do you hear, Wilkes?
Oh, no, we'll leave the boy alone.
Leave him alone? Leave him alone? I'm your boy change, you silly thing. Everyone left him alone. His mother left him alone. His father left him alone. Everyone left him alone except dear old Aunt Noah.
You are a one.
Hey, Wilkes, how's your mother?
You leave my mother out of this. She's dead.
Aw. What'd she die of? Shortage of breath?
Never you mind.
Oh, but I do mind.
We better not say any more about this. You hear?
Better not. Better not, you don't mind. The chief of it. The warehouse chief of it. My mother, he said. She was a nice one, she was. You know, Wilkes? It couldn't be helped now, and it couldn't be helped then. Very sorry for it. But you know, your mother was a regular right now bad one.
What did you say?
A regular right now bad one. It was a good thing she got what she did, or she'd be doing hard labor in prison, as I guess not.
Take him back.
Oh,
he's a little starved down.
Somebody kick him over.
you sing? Student lodging?
Yes.
Were they in lodgings?
No.
Money?
Not the farthing. Do you live in London?
When I'm at home. I suppose you want some place to sleep tonight. Don't you? Are you?
Taken you so strong, it's clear we're
to it.
Sir.
I hope I shall have the honor of your intimate acquaintance. Leave him alone, leave him alone. We are all very glad to see you, Oliver, very. Charlie, draw a tub near the fire for Oliver. Dodger, take off the sausages.
They're still.
Oh, shut up and drink your gin. Oh, did you notice the pocket handkerchiefs, my dear? Oh, yes, they're all hung up, ready for the wash, the wash. That's all, Oliver, that's all.
Is this a laundry day, sir?
Well, not exactly, my boy. I suppose laundry would be a very nice thing indeed, but our line of business pays a little better, don't it, boys?
Shut up!
You see, Ila, in this life, one thing counts in the bank, large amounts. I'm afraid these don't grow on trees. You've got to pick a pocket or two. Got to pick a pocket or two, boys. You've got to pick a pocket or two. Better pick a pocket or two. You've got to pick a pocket or two. Boys, you've got to pick a pocket or two. What a crook gave away all he took. A charity's fine, subscribe to mine. Get out and pick a pocket or two. You've got to pick a pocket or two. Boys, you've got to pick a pocket or two. From Bill Sykes, he can whip what he likes. I recall he started small. He had to pick a pocket or two. You've got to pick a pocket or two. Boys, you've got to pick a pocket or two. Passing by, something nice, it takes his eye. Everything's clear, attack the rear. It wants to pick a pocket or two. You've got to pick a pocket or two. Boys, you've got to pick a pocket or two. Someone rich, both my thumbs start to itch. Only to find some peace of mind, I've got to pick a pocket or two. You've got to pick a pocket or two. Boys, you've got to pick a pocket or two. Might be. Oh, but they're very nicely made. Ingenious workman, ain't he, Oliver?
Very ingenious, sir.
And what have you got, my dear?
Nose rags.
Oh, nose rags. Oh, well, they're very nice ones. Light blue and dark blue. Oh, but Charlie, you haven't embroidered them too well. We'll have to pick the initials out with a needle. You'll need to learn how to do this too, Oliver, my dear. Oh, won't you, boys? But in the meantime, you'll have to learn how to make wallets, like Dodger and Charlie here. You'd like that, wouldn't you, my dear?
Yes, sir. If you would teach me.
Oh, certainly, my boy, certainly. No fee. Just do everything that Dodger and Charlie do. Make them your models, my dear. Especially Dodger. He's going to be a regular little Bill Sykes. Now then, is my handkerchief protruding from my pocket?
Yes, sir. I can just see the corner.
See if you can take it out without me feeling it, like you saw the others do. Rum tum tum, tum tum tum, pum pum pum, pum pum. Skiddly ti ti ri ti ti, tarapa tapa tapa tum tum. You've got to pick a pocket or two. Clever lad. I never saw a sharper boy. Here's sixpence for you. I have to go to the bank. If you go on this way, Oliver, you'll be the greatest man of all time. Yes, you're quite the gentleman now. You've got sixpence on credit. You've got a home and a profession, eh, boys? All right, now, bedtime, all of you. There's a hard day's work ahead. Oliver, you can sleep down there. Dodger, settle down and take your hat off in bed. All right, everyone, come on, go to sleep. Oh, Oliver, how about a nightcap? I'm afraid the Wedgwood's in the safe. Good night, my dear. Go on, go to sleep, you too. Good night. You got to pick a pocket or two. I'm a real miser, you know. But can I help it? I just like to look at it. This is my little pleasure. A cup of coffee and a quick count-up. mean, who's gonna look after me in me old age?
Will you, buddy? Will you?
You! Why are you awake? What have you seen? Quick, quick, speak! I want to hear in detail you saw.
I'm sorry for disturbing you, sir. I couldn't sleep anymore.
Were you awake 5 minutes ago?
No, sir.
2 minutes ago?
Not sure, sir.
Be sure, be sure.
All right, then. I'm sure, sir.
All right. If you're sure, then I'm sure. Of course, I knew all along, my dear. I was only trying to frighten you. You're a brave boy, Oliver. A brave boy. Did you see any of the pretty things, my dear?
Yes, sir.
Well, they're mine. My little property. All I've got to live on in me old age. It's a terrible thing. Old age.
May I get up, sir?
Certainly, you may get up. There's a basin of water there on the fire. You can go have a wash.
I washed yesterday, sir.
Well, today's your birthday. Wash!
Plumbing and slab!
Oh, it's Nancy. Wake up, everybody. Wake up. The ladies are here. Too much gin can be a terrible thing for a pure young girl.
Well, what's wrong with a drop of danger then, Mr. Fagin? After all, it's the only bit of excitement we have around here. And who would deny us this small pleasure? Would you?
Me?
Thank you. Mind of fire, fire.
Okay, you lot, let's go.
Oh, I'm too busy there.
Introduce you to our new lodger, Mr. Oliver Twist, Esquire, Nancy, and, Bet.
Oh, charm.
Oh, yes, we're all equality. We're all ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, quality. You wouldn't have quality if you saw it. Oh. None of you. Except Dodge. Oh. Have you seen the way them quality gentlemen treats their ladies?
Of course I have.
Well, shall we show them how it's done?
Definitely.
Oh, go on, Nancy, then. Give us a
pressure. Rod, shut up, you lot. How's it going, Dodge? It's all bowing, that's all.
And now, gently, your pockets. Gently,
oh,
my
God. Yes. I'll go last. No, all go last. No, I'll go last.
I do.
Soon. You can go, but while you're working, and this place I 20, ain't that a lovely tune? Be back soon.
Back in 10 days, I have tomorrow. Well, this is to me, said, but you love parties as we sorrow. They're wearing this dish. You're in this bitch, but too. So long, but the big picture, you're well be back soon. And Chidio, but be back, see back in 10 days, I have tomorrow. Well, you're not.
tree, but now she's on the wrong tree. She had to fell a poodle and meet her alone. One reason crying, she's made a better lion. She's glad to bring the corn in and join in this song.
Thank you.
Fagin looks worried.
One of us, Bill, a new boy, went out on his first job today with Dodger. I'm afraid he may say something which will get us into trouble.
Oh, my dear, it's very likely. You're blown apart, Fagin.
And I'm afraid, you see, that if the game was up with us, it might be up with a good many more. And it would come out rather worse for you than it would for me, my dear.
Now somebody's got to find out what's been done or said. If he ain't talked yet, there's still a chance we might get him back without suspicion. We'll never moment he dares step out of that house. Now, who's he gonna go?
The very thing. Nancy, my dear. Oh, what do you say?
The very thing.
That won't do. So it's no use trying it on food.
And just what do you mean by that remark?
I say, Bill.
Why, Nancy, you're perfect for the part. Nobody up that way knows anything about you.
Well, as I don't want him to neither, it's rather more no than yes with me, Bill.
She'll go, Fagin.
No, she won't, Fagin.
Yes, she will, Fagin. Oh! Well, go on and get out of here, all of you. Go on.
I know where I must be. A clear True just. Come right in, Doctor. I think you'll find a great improvement in the boy.
That, sir, is for me to decide.
Thank you, Mrs. Bedford.
Yes, sir.
Well, my child, how do you feel this morning?
Much better, thank you, sir. May I stay here always?
If you wish. If you wish, yes. Now, here's the doctor to see you.
Feeling a great deal better, are you not?
Yes, thank you, sir.
Yes, I knew you were. And you're feeling hungry, too, aren't you?
No, sir.
No. Knew you weren't hungry. He's not hungry, Mrs. Bedwin.
No, Doctor.
Feeling a little sleepy, aren't you?
No, sir.
Not feeling sleepy? Then he's not even thirsty. Are you thirsty?
Yes, sir, I am rather thirsty.
Just as I expected. It's natural for him to be thirsty. Give him a little tea.
Yes, sir.
May I go out, sir?
I think you may, for a little fresh air. But make sure he doesn't get too warm or too cold. Use your judgment.
Yes, Doctor.
Oliver, you should be glad to be able to get up and out again.
Yes, sir.
And Doctor, I want to ask you something. Now, you knew my thoughts of Agnes. Have you noticed the extraordinary resemblance and likeness of that boy's face to my daughter?
I can't say that I do. The only thing I know, there are two different types of boys. There's the B-face type and the mealy-face type.
Oh, which one is Oliver?
He's the mealy-face type. Where did he come from?
Oh, didn't I tell you? He was arrested for stealing my pocket handkerchief. But when one of the shopkeepers told us what really happened and the magistrate released him, I brought him here to make amends for that. Doctor, I find myself strangely attracted to that child.
He's the seed of you, my dear friend. You know, he's had a fever. And you know, fevers are not just peculiar to good people. They happen to bad people also sometimes. You know, he stole your handkerchief once, and he'll steal it again and again.
Oh, no. I'm sure that boy will never know. Yes?
Books for the bookseller.
Oh, yes. Thank you. Oh, dear boy, come back. Oh, well, he's gone. I particularly wish to return these books today.
Why don't you let Oliver return them?
Yes, sir.
I know he returned them safely. Ah, when my dead body he returned them.
Very well. If you should wish, you shall. Now, here's what I want you to do. I want you to go down to the bookseller. Tell him you've come here to pay the £4.08 that Mr. Brownlow owes. Now, here's £5. Now, there's no need to rush. It's just down the road a bit.
Yes, sir.
But I shall expect you back in 10 minutes. Now, Mrs. Bessie.
Yes, sir.
We shall see. 10 minutes.
Thank you.
So his parents were hard working, respectable people. Nearly broke his mother's heart. Thank you, please.
Young wretch.
Go home, you little brute.
Ow!
I won't. She's not my sister. Got no sister. Got no father. No mother, neither.
Just listen to her.
Then tell her to let me go.
See, here's your sister. You can't hide that, can he? Make him come home. Or kill his mother and father.
What the devil's this? Young Oliver, come on home to your poor mother. Young dog, come on home. And what books are these? You've been stealing again, have you? Give him here. He's nothing but a thief and a vagabond. Come on home to your poor mother, you little wretch. Come on, you've got it all worried.
Someone, and I don't care for the consequences.
Why, Nancy, you're wonderful.
Marlowe today. Such talent! What an actress!
Why? Take care, I do know what to do. It's not a war. I'll put my finger on some of you, and I don't care who I hang with. Oh.
You? Do you know who you are? And what you are?
Oh, yes. I know all right who I am and what I am.
Then keep quiet or quiet you for a good long time to come. Nancy, my dear, you're a nice and coming on. All your mane and genteel. Rubbish! A big picture for a child, as you call her, to make a friend of.
Lord help me, I am. And I wish I'd been struck dead in the street before I lent a hand in bringing him here. After today, he's a thief, a liar, all that's bad from this day forth. Isn't there enough of you with that you're beaten to death?
Oh, come, come. Sykes, we must have civil words.
Oh,
civil words.
Like a...
Civil words? You deserve this from me. I thieved for you when I was a child at Harper's age, and for 12 years since. Don't forget it.
Well, if you have it, you're living.
So how to win friends and to influence people? so how? I'm reviewing the situation. I must quickly look up everyone I know. Title people with a station who can help me make a real impressive show. I will run a suite at Claridge's and run a fleet of carriages and wave at all the duchesses with friendliness as much as is befitting of my new estate. A good morning to you, magistrate. I think I better think it out again. So where shall I go? Somebody? Who do I know? Nobody. All my dearest companions have always been villains and thieves. At my time of life, I should start turning over new leaves. I'm reviewing the situation. If you want to eat, you've got to earn a pound. Is it such a humiliation for a robber to perform an honest job? So a job I'm getting possibly, I wonder who the boss will be. I wonder if he'll take to me, what bonuses he'll make to me. I'll start at 8 and finish late at normal rate and all. But wait, I think I better think it out again. What happens when I'm 70? Must come a time, 70, when you're old and it's cold, and who cares if you live or you die? The one consolation's the money you may have put by. I'm reviewing the situation. I'm a baron and a baron, I shall stay. You'll be seeing no transformation, but it's wrong to be a rogue in every way. I don't want nobody hurt for me or made to do the hurt for me. This rotten life is not for me. It's getting far too hot for me. Don't want no one to rob for me, but who will find a job for me? There is no in-between for me, but who will change the scene for me? I think I better think it out again. Hey!
It seems an age. I sold myself for 6 teaspoons, a pair of sugar tongs, a milk pot, with a small quantity of secondhand furniture, and 20 pounds cash. I went very reasonable. Cheap. Dirt cheap.
Cheap? You would have been dear at any price, and dear enough I'd paid for you. Lord above knows that. Do you want to sit there snoring all day?
I will sit here as long as I think proper, madam. And although I was not snoring, I will snore, gape, sneeze, laugh, or cry as the humor strikes me. That being my prerogative.
Your prerogative?
I said the word, madam. It is the prerogative of a man to command.
And what's the prerogative of a woman in the name of goodness?
To obey. Your late unfortunate husband should have taught that to you. And then perhaps he'd be alive today. And I wish he were, poor man.
Oh! Oh, you hard-hearted brute!
and washes the face. So cry away.
How dare you speak to me like that?
You wake me, love. Here. Now talk about your prerogative, if you dare.
Shut up!
Here.
And take yourself away from here before I do something desperate. Well, are you going?
Certainly. Certainly, dear. Certainly. You do get very violent. I'm going.
Who's there? It's Matron. Come here, Nira. It's old Sally, ma'am. Says she's got something to tell you that's got to be heard. And she won't die quiet until you do. Send her away.
Go on, get out of it.
But I'm your old friend, Ernie.
Go on, get out of it.
Now listen to me. Once, right here, in this very room, in that very bed, I nursed a pretty young creature that was brought into the house with her feet all cut and bruised with walking. She gave birth to a boy and died.
What about her?
I robbed her. All she had in it around your neck was gold.
Gold? Yes, go on. Yes, what of it?
This is it. A locket. She whispered in my ear that if a poor baby should live, they would come when it might feel proud to hear its poor mother name. I believe she came from a good rich family.
His name was? Yes?
Oliver.
We must retrieve that boy, Mr. Bumble.
Yes, indeed, madam. Yes, indeed.
Oliver, Oliver. That was the bite with the large appetite. Oliver. Oliver, apparently he's from a rich family. To think we nearly stupidly went and lost track of him. If the truth were known, we both were delighted at seeing the back of him. Oliver, Oliver, what will he do? His kid and the stupid will praise the day. Somebody gave us Oliver.
About the boy, Oliver Twist.
I have come in answer to your advertisement, sir. Bumble is my name, beadle of the workhouse, where the boy was cared for. From where he was apprenticed to the undertaker? Where he ran away from?
Yes, yes, but do you know where the boy is now?
No, sir, nothing more than nobody.
But what do you know of him?
This trinket was given by the boy's dying mother to my dear wife just before she passed away. The boy's dying mother, that is, not my dear wife.
You say when the boy left the workhouse, he went to an undertaker.
Yes, Mr. Sowerberry, the undertaker, took Oliver from us. Gave us £5 for him.
Good God, man, you mean to tell me you sold him just like an animal?
Well, sir, it was Mrs. Bumble that actually authorized the sale.
Really? Then indeed, I shall see that neither of you are ever employed in a position of trust again. No, you may leave my house.
I hope this will not deprive me of my present parochial position, sir.
Indeed it will, and you should think yourself better off.
But, sir, it was Mrs. Bumble that would do it.
That is absolutely no excuse. You were present at the time the boy was being sold, and therefore are twice as guilty in the eye of the law. For the law supposes, sir, that your wife acts under your direction.
If the law supposes that, sir, then the law is an ass. If that is the eye of the law,
then the worst I can wish him is that his eye be opened. By experience. By experience.
Thank you. Down.
Don't take him back, Joe. For pity's sake, let him go. Let him go. Why are you looking at me, love?
It's a dark night, my love.
What's light enough? What I've got to do.
I wasn't going to blow the garden. Honest, I wasn't. I wouldn't say nothing. Bill! Bill!
I saw this shadow figure disappearing.
Can you tell us what he looked like?
Yes, he was a broad-shouldered, well-built man. He wore a dark coat and a tall hat.
Thank you. Thank you.